Hello everyone, Zundert back again with another Call of War video. Today I will be playing as Poland. Well, I've not really played a lot in Europe, so I figured playing Poland would be pretty cool. Right here you can see my build up, a bit of tank factories. Also some buildings that can produce RT units and also some anti-air. Of course we need an air force and also a navy. For our research, we're just researching some fighters and also destroyers. It's already set our route because Germany will be our first target. Of course, I'm not alone in the map. We're also here with Turkey. He's getting attacked by Greece, but I hope he'll be fine. It's Moondoge, the worst player we have. No, I'm kidding. Really good player, really like him. Also, we have Romania. This is Marks for you. Also, a pretty solid player. If it loads, yes, here you go. We also have Ukraine on our side. It will be played by Willy. And last but certainly not least, we have Graafschap in, I'm not sure what to call this, the big blue country in the north of Russia, I suppose. So, yeah, those will be helping us for this map. Poland is invading Germany. Not something you hear every day, but it's really happening in our map on day 2. Well, we're pushing into Germany, like I said, with some artillery and infantry on the north side. Of course, they're too aggressive, so they will bomb the units automatically. Our friend Romania is also doing some good work against Yugoslavia. Yugoslavia is getting some help from Italy, but I think he will be fine. Turkey defeated Greece, like I thought he would, so well done to him. Also looks like he's pushing a bit in the Middle East, so looks like he got it all under control. Also Ukraine is just capturing Russia, and our big blue blob friend is invading Scandinavia. I normally don't make two recordings in one day, but I thought it was pretty necessary right here. Germany is actually pushing pretty hard back, so it's pretty unexpected, but luckily we have our cruisers here and we will try to push the coast. Also, we pushed into one of our like main cities, which is really bad. Romania is doing its thing. Also Turkey is pretty much conquering the Middle East pretty well. Ukraine also succeeded in its goal, and our blue blob also did. As you can see right here, we've taken Germany finally. Also England is getting a bit suspicious of our cruisers, and rightly so, because he's our next target. Romania already begun invading England, so we'll join him shortly. You'll also notice we are not taking Berlin, because we'll get a morale boost of a few percent, so our province will not revolt by the day change. We've conquered the European part of England. We've divided it with Romania. He will probably go after Spain, and we will try and land on the main island. The big blue blob has also almost conquered the whole of Scandinavia. Ukraine has declared war on Kazakhstan. Kazakhstan is pretty big, so he needs to really watch out. I think he will manage though. He has some good stacks. Also, the big blue blob is moving towards Siberia. Also pretty massive at the moment. Turkey is pushing through the Middle East and now warring with Egypt, so he can get a foot on mainland Africa. He's also boarding with Kazakhstan, but I don't think Ukraine needs the help, so we'll probably stay out of it for the most part. Score-wise, we're doing better than yesterday. Day 5 is upon us. We've captured England almost entirely. Only a bit of Ireland remained, and of course the London capital, which we will take before the day change. Let's reroute this one here. Also Romania, and I took Spain and split it a bit. Turkey has really set a good foothold in Africa by taking Egypt. Ukraine and the big blue blob have really advanced. They're threatening Asia by now. They're using their navy pretty well, I think. And yeah, it's just all coming together. So it's day 7 and we've decided to invade Africa with the three of us. We made the landing using, of course, our navy and air force. Algeria is our target at the moment, but French Sudan, the pink one right here, will be a pretty big threat. Algeria is just being taken by some armored cars and also some other stacks. Our air force will clear the way for us. Let's get them over here in Africa, because I have a feeling we're gonna need them a whole bunch. Of course split them, because stacks of 10 are most efficient. In the meantime, let's get this out of here. Well, in the meantime, we've really worked on our economy. The factories are being upgraded. We need a lot of rare materials and oil, so those are the first to level 4. It's glitching out a bit. And of course, food and goods are not something we really need at the moment, so they are still level 1. In the score department, we're doing pretty well, 4th. So it's day 9, only 2 days have passed, and we're now just invading French Sudan. Let's get this navy stack also here. I don't think he's... well, he has much of a chance really, because our air force is also has also arrived. Some more stacks have also arrived, so yeah, he's pretty much done for. It's only the question how much cities can we actually grab. Turkey has pushed all the way to Ethiopia and taking him out. You'll probably take south or north Sudan next. Don't know which one it is. I think south. The Middle East has also been taken completely now. South India is making some battleships, as you can see here. Turkey's just spying on him. Manchukuo is sending a lot of troops into Ukraine's land. You should probably watch out for it. The big blue blob is also bordering with Manchukuo. He's actually at war with him. Yeah, he's also pushing. So they will probably take Manchukuo out between the two of them. So only like 24 hours later, and French Sudan has officially fallen. I think we can officially say it. He has a little bit of a stack here, but as you can see, not a lot of air defense. While our stack, not really split efficiently, has a lot of infantry attack points. He also has something in his capital, but just fighters and trucks, so not really a big issue. Turkey is invading both the Indias right now, first up working his navy. Submarines against battleships, always really good. For the submarines, of course. Ukraine has also pushed far beyond Manchukuo and is now invading Burma. The big blue blob, as we keep calling him, has also been really helpful with Manchukuo, looks like it. He's also invading the AI country that pretty much connects you to America. So it will be interesting to see if he actually goes to America. I'm not quite sure yet. So we've reached day 12. We're right now invading the Congo. We're bombing one of his coastal cities. We've had an army reveal, so we know exactly what to expect. I don't think we'll run into a lot of trouble at all. Also, Romania is also lining up the front line with some pretty good stacks. So yeah, absolutely zero worries about the outcome of this war. Back in our precious homeland of Poland, we are collecting our units in stacks and, Who knows who our next target will be. Our research is looking pretty good. Of course, the armored cars are pretty high level, the Air Force. Also, some of the Navy units that are pretty important. Also, some rocket artillery. Never wrong to use those. In the meantime, Ukraine has really gone nuts. In just those 2 days, he has captured all of this land. Absolutely insane. Big Blue Blob, trusty as always, is also doing pretty good. We just have to clean up some of the AI countries if we really want to. Turkey has also made some big steps in Africa. Score-wise, at the moment, we're less of our coalition, but it's still pretty good. So, it's day 13, and we're at the moment attacking Madagascar. Romania is attacking further down south. We're finally splitting up and actually taking out our own countries. We had an army review for Madagascar, so we know what to expect, and it's not that bad, so I think he'll be taken in about 1 or 2 days. Turkey is also done with India, and Ukraine is also done with Eastern Asia. The Big Blue Blob is swallowing the whole of Japan to add to his Big Blue Empire. Next up, we'll be trying to land in North America with, for example, this tech and our Air Force stationed here in Spain. So, the day of boarding has begun. Well, with that I mean we're traveling to America officially now. We've regrouped in Spain and are now moving to North America. We'll be taking, of course, our Navy, some armored cars, a lot of RT and anti-air, and some tank destroyers, very important. The Air Force, we can't miss those, of course. Our Air Force is pretty advanced, as you can see right here. Also, the RT units are pretty far researched. Tanks, well, not really the normal tanks, but the tank destroyers and armored cars are pretty far along. Also, the Navy is pretty okay. Our friend Romania is traveling with some more basic units, but he still has a lot of them, so we'll give North America a big shock. Score-wise, we're still not doing insanely well, but it will pick up once we're in North America, I'm sure. We also took entire Africa, so that's pretty nice. There's still some stacks here, but they can defend, you know. Maybe someone will evade, you will never know. Let's move them to our province so it doesn't have any rebellions. So like I said a few days ago, some of the AI countries now be taken by our allies. Just to clean it up, some AI has also declared war on Ukraine. Its popularity is probably pretty low at the moment. And we're just steaming along. So, the day of the landing is finally here. Well, we've landed in Florida, pretty much. As Poland, invading North America, where Cuba and Kansas are pretty much the superpowers. Everything can happen in Kalafar, as you can see. Let's split our planes into stacks of 30, that way the attacking bombers and also the tactical ones have air cover. Let's leave these at our stacks. Our cruisers are due for an upgrade, so let's do that. Upgrade them, yeah, pretty cheap. Our stacks that we are using are these ones. They are pretty good, just look at these stats. Pretty amazing, actually. I would recommend using a combination of these stacks. They're pretty expensive, but it's definitely worth it. So the enemy, Kansas, is rolling in with like medium tanks and also some other units in the stack. Our friend Romania is bombing away at Cuba. He's rolling in with some heavy tanks, which could be a tiny bit of a problem. But I think our Air Force will decide to fight right here. I hope so, at least. Ukraine and the Big Blue Blob have cleaned up a bit, also Turkey. Of course, Netherlands couldn't survive We can't have anything nice, so let's take them out as well. So it's pretty much day two of our landing in North America. And all is well, I think. We countered the attack from Kansas and Cuba. They just pushed through. The Air Force was of course a big help, as we expected. So yeah, we spiked a bit in points, still last of our group, but maybe that can change. We think tomorrow we will have enough points to win this map, so hopefully we can get a bit more points on the board. So yeah, let's make the most of it. So, like we suspected, day 20 was the last day in this map. Our coalition got enough points to trigger our win. Here in North America we did pretty good, I think, together with Romania. Romania, of course, taking out North Mexico. South America is pretty much still intact, we haven't touched them at all. I was about to bomb them with my navy, but, you know. And for the most part, Europe wasn't a problem at all, and we got the most final points in North America. Let's check out the score. We've not finished in last, actually fourth of our group, which is pretty okay. Also a big shout out to one of my alliance members, Staske. He's been helping me out with a lot of Call of War stuff recently, so big shout out to him. He really is a legend. I would like to thank you guys for watching. If you have any feedback or questions or even criticism, please put it down in the comments. I will read all of it and maybe even respond, if I can respond to the question, of course. So good luck on the battlefield to you all.